Welcome to all of you. Myself, Ravindra Chavan, Assistant Professor, Department of Electronics Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. So, today in this session, we will discuss the serial communication in 8051. The learning outcome of this session is, after this session, student will be able to design the system which supports the serial data transfer and receive using the microcontroller 8051. Outline of our discussions is like this. First, we will go through the basics of the serial communication. Next, we will see how the 8051 supports the serial communication. And third one is, we will write the algorithm for serial data transfer and receive. The first, you should know what do you mean by a data communication. Now, in the processor-based system, data communication means the exchange of data or exchange of information between the devices. Now, this information can be exchanged in number of ways, that is called the types of different communication. The way in which the data is transmitted or received, depending upon that, the classification is done like simplex communication, half duplex communication, full duplex communication. In simplex communication, the transmitter and the receivers are fixed. The transmitter is transmitting the information all the times, and the receiver is receiving the information all the times. The best example of this type of communication is the radio broadcasting. The next communication type is called the half duplex communication. In half duplex communication, the device can be work either as a transmitter or receive. Means data can be sent in both the directions, but only in one direction at the same time. So the example of half duplex communication you will find in the device walkie-talkie, where the device, normally we are using the telephone which supports the full duplex communication. In full duplex communication, data can be transmitted and the received in both the direction at the same time. Another classification of the data transfer is done ki how the data is transferred. So first type is called the parallel data transfer. Second is called the serial data transfer. In parallel data transfer, the number of lines, wires are drawn between the transmitter and the receiver. Normally, in the controller-based system, the 8 or more wires are used to transfer or receive the data. It is the parallel data transfer is used for data transfer over short distance, that is few feet away, because the more number of lines or wires are required. But here, as the number of bits can be transferred or received at the same time, the parallel data transfer is the faster one. While in serial data transfer, only one wire is sufficient to transmit the data between transmitter and receiver. Now, in serial data transfer, only one bit is transferred at the same time. Now, serial data transfer, mainly it is preferable while transferring the data over long distance. Now, in this data transfer, only one bit is transmit at the same time. That's why serial data transfer is slower compared to the parallel data transfer. Now the serial data transfer are classified in mainly in two categories. One is called the synchronous data transfer, and second is called asynchronous data transfer. In synchronous data transfer, before sending the actual data or the information, the predefined sync characters are exchanged between transmitter and the receiver. And when transmitter and receiver are get synchronized to each other, then the block of data is transferred at a time. Means one by one, all the characters or bytes are transferred. In asynchronous data transfer, the data transfer takes the character bytes. If it will send the one character, after that the second character, and so on. Now to transfer the one character in asynchronous data transfer, the frame is designed, which contains the start bit, then the 8 bit of the characters to be transferred. Now normally to transfer the data serially or the character serially, its ASCII value is to be used. So 8 bit ASCII value of the character to be transferred, and lastly the stop bit. So for each character, one frame is designed, and then these frames are sent one by one. Now in the serial data transfer in 8051, for that the two pins are provided called the RxD and TxD, which are multiplexed with the port pin P3.0 and P3.1 respectively. P3.0, that is the receive pin, is used to receive the one bit of information at a time, and one bit of information can be transmitted through the pin P3.1, that is called the TxD pin. And this 8051 supports only the asynchronous data transfer. For one character to be transferred, a frame is designed, which is shown below. The first bit is called the start bit. Then the 8-bit ASCII value of character, which is actually to be transmit, and lastly the stop bits. In 8051, the start bit is kept at logic 0 and stop bit is kept at logic 1. Now for the serial data transfer in 8051, the two special function registers are provided. The one is called SBUF and second one is called SCON. The SBUF register is used to store the actual character to be transferred via the TxD line. So whenever you are going to transfer the character serially, it requires to put that character first in the SBUF register. Whenever we are putting the any character in SBUF register, the transmission will start. And whatever the character received through RxD pin, that character is also get stored into the SBUF register. Now internally, this SBUF are the two different entities, two different registers, but we are accessing these registers with the same address, same name, that is the SBUF. But these two registers are differentiated by their operation. The one used for transmission, that SBUF is always written by the controller, and the SBUF which receives the received character, that SBUF register is always read by the 8051. Next special function register is provided, which is named as SCON register. Now SCON register is used to configure the modes of operation of serial communication, and the bit format defined for The SCON resistors are shown below. The 3 MSB bits, SM0, SM1 and SM2, these 3 bits are used to decide the actual mode of operation, like this. So when SM0 is 0, SM1 is 0, we are saying that the 8051 is operating in mode 0. Similarly, when SM0 is 0, SM1 is 1, we are selecting the mode 1 operation of the 8051, and so on. Now, the mode 0 is work as simply 8-bit shift register mode. So, normally, the peoples are not going for the use of the mode 0. Okay. Then the widely used mode of operation is the 8-bit UART. Okay, for that SM0 must be 0 and SM1 must be 1. And SM2 bit enables the multiprocessing capability of the 8051 in mode 2 and mode 3. As far as the data transfer rate, that is the baud rate, is concerned, the baud rate is variable in mode 1 and mode 3. Where in mode 0 and the mode 2, the baud rate is fixed. Now, the last 2 bits, which is called the flag bits, TI, transmit interrupt flag, and RI stands for receive interrupt flag. Now, this TI flag is set when 8051 completes the transmission of a character to indicate that now the 8051 is ready to transfer the next byte or the next character. RI flag is set when 8051 receives the character and placed in the SBUF register. And it indicates that this byte has been received and should be read before it is lost. Now, to enable the receiver of the 8051, REN bit is to be set. If REN bit is 0, the receiver is disabled. And TB8 and RB8 are used when you are designing the frame with the 11 bits, where the 11 bit is used as a parity bit, which is used for parity or the error detection. Then the algorithm for to transfer the data serially, as far as the 8051 is concerned. First, initialize the timer 1 in mode 2, timer mode, to decide the data transfer rate, that is the baud rate. Now you pause the video and recall how to initialize the timer 1. Now to initialize the timer 1, load the TMOD register with the value 20H to operate timer 1 in mode 2 timer mode. Internally, only the timer 1 is associating with the serial communication. That's why to decide the baud rate, all the times timer 1 is to be used. After initializing the timer 1 in mode 2 timer mode, next step is load the TH1 register with one of the values to set the baud rate for serial data transfer. Now, how will you find the TH1 value? For that, use the formula, that is baud rate is equal to 2 raised to S mod divided by 32 whole multiplied by oscillator frequency divided by 12 into 256 minus TH1. Now the baud rate we are deciding. So baud rate, it is always known quantity. So only unknown quantity is TH1. So from this you find the TH1 value to get the required baud rate and put in the TH1 register. This SMOD bit is from the PCON register. By default, SMOD bit is reset. So this bit is provided to double the baud rate by keeping the same value in TH1 register by setting the SMOD bit. Then load the SCON register with the value 50H to select the mode 1 with receiver enable, where an 8-bit data is framed with start bit and stop bit. So first start bit will be sent, then the 8 bit of the actual character, and lastly the stop bit will be gets transmit. Next, start the timer so that the clock will be generated. Then clear the timer interrupt flag to indicate that the previous character has been transmitted. Then write the character byte to be transferred serially into the SBUF register. When you are putting the character in the SBUF register, the transmission will start. Now, next, you have to wait till the transmission is not completed. For that, you continuously monitor the status of TI flag bit to see if the character has been transferred completely or not. If you find TI bit is set, that means the character is transferred. Now you can put the next character into the SBUF register. So before that, you clear the TI flag and put the next character to be transferred in the SBUF register. So references used for this particular topic: microcontrollers by Ajay Deshmukh, and 8051 and embedded C program by Mazidi and Mazidi. Thank you.